Speaker of the panel is Joanna Kotsemba, if it's the right way to pronounce your surname, Kotsemba. So Joanna is a theoretician and cultural animator interested in the theater for social change and socially engaged theater. And she has graduated from the Institute of Contemporary Culture at the University of Lodz. And currently she is writing on her PhD at the Institute of Polish Culture at the University of Warsaw. She works in many theaters across Poland, but also outside of Poland. And today she's going to present us some insights on her theoretical working. And her theme is politically engaged participatory theater in the public space. We're very happy that you are here, and that would be interesting to know more. How is it going with politically engaged theater? So the word is yours. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. I'm very honored to be here with you and to present in front of you some theories and historical stuff. I'm very sorry that it's gonna be not so practical as the presentations were before, but I still hope that you will find it interesting and maybe also useful. I will say some few words about the theory of the politically engaged participatory theater, and also I will give you three examples of them. Two of them are historical, one of them is contemporary, and this last one, which is contemporary, is well known in Poland, and is also the practice in which I participated and which I did as a one from the group, with the group. So I hope that you will find it useful. Let's start from the consideration that, as you can see in my presentation, there is three very important context of the theater and three important terms, which somehow go together, but on the other side they are separately. So this is politically engaged theater, which is one thing. The another thing is participatory theater, and the third thing is theater in of or of the public space. As I will explain later, political engagement and participatory theater go together, and theater in or off the public space is something which can be considered as separately. So just a few examples of the politically engaged theater. So the one which is of course very famous, the Living Theater from US, and the second one, which is contemporary from Poland, this is Chór Kobiet by Marta Górnicka. And participatory theater, for example, Theater 21, and from Warsaw. I have no time to go into detail, so if you are interested, I would like to tell you more maybe during discussion. So this is the great example of the participatory theater. I will tell you later the definition of participatory theater. Here we have the theater in the public space, as well a contemporary example. As you know, there's lots of examples of the theaters which do the performance in the public space, but they are not very interested in the public space as it is. They are just they don't talk about the public space in their performance. They just do the performance in the public space. So this is the difference between the theater in the public space and theater of the public space. When we say about theater of the public space, it means that the theater group is also interested in the public space as a topic of the performance. Of course, the division is, it's very hard to make the division between it, but I think that we can understand it somehow that that this is two different things. So one more general reflection that probably, as you know, the relationship created during each performance, which is obligatory for theater, the relationship between the actors and the viewer always reflects in social life. And one of those who wrote it about who wrote about it in a very specific and interesting way and went into details is of course Victor Turner, who was the British anthropologist, and he proposed such a circle. Take a look that how it goes. So for him, here we have the Victor Turner, nice photo. And for him, for the other theater sociologists, each performance always reflects in social life, and social life always reflects in theater. So we can understand that each director, each actors, each theater practitioner has a possibility to influence on people's life, yeah? But the creators of participatory theater have even a much bigger possibility to influence on human life, because they do not only talk from the scene about the particular topics, but they also engage people to the theatrical activities and take them on the scene and allow them to prepare their own stage statement. So they allow them to create the situation by which they can on their own reflect on social life. So of course this is very difficult to make the definition of the participatory theater, but I was trying to propose something, and this is my definition which I did. And of course we can discuss this definition, but as you can see, I will read it. The participatory theater is the theater which involves the participation and creative activities of amateurs, representatives of the different social group. And what is important, it is inclusive, engaging community. This is very close idea to the emancipation through art. And participatory theater is in fact the strategy of the socially engaged art, which consists of collective co-deciding about the artistic and social form of works or activities. And its essence is the creative activity of group of people, artists and amateur artists, which are invited to act together in an artistic way. So now it's the question, how close is to from participatory theater to politically engaged theater, and from theater in the public space to politically engaged theater? So in my opinion, which I would like to share with you, it's very close. I mean, participatory theater, what I want to say is always politically engaged theater. And theater in the public space is also almost every time politically engaged theater. And now, why I think that it works like this. So I would like to remind you about this French philosopher Jacques Rancière. I'm sorry, Jacques Rancière, whose theory connects aesthetic theory with the whose theory connect aesthetic with the politics. And for him, I would like to quote him. So, politics is about reconfiguration, the distribution of sensuality, about visualizing what was not visible, and about recognizing the voices of people who were perceived as noisy animals as important. So politics, it's about making certain narratives, making certain discourse, histories, activities, possibilities, certain groups of people visible or not visible, and audible or not audible. And sharing these possibilities of being visible or not visible, and sharing the possibilities to hide something or to show something, is in fact politic. So as you can understand from this, art, and especially participatory art, is very politically engaged, because it always it is about making people visible, because when they are on the stage, when they show something, when they talk from what they think, what they want to say, it's about making them visible. Yeah. So, so for me, the participatory theater is always politically engaged theater, and theater in the public space is, and when it happens in the public space, it makes it even more visible. So it, the political engagement of this performance is even bigger. But so if we agree with this, on the bottom of this you have the word politics. So if we agree with this, we can go further and say that, okay, each participatory theater is always politically engaged, but it is not engaged to the same level. I mean, we can still have the gradation of the politically engaged theaters, even though all of them are very politically engaged. And with help comes the division between the division between parapolitics, politics, and metapolitics. So there is, there is one Polish philosopher whose name is Paweł Mościcki, and he wrote about his idea to divide parapolitic, politic, and metapolitic. And what is it? What it is? So parapolitic is the fight for gaining and maintaining political power, and it is understood as statecraft in the center way. And parapolitic is the fight again between politicians or their support groups, and parapolitic is also demonstrations against acts of law. It is the discussion about the law. It is the discussion about the rule, political rule, about the possibilities, about the acts of law, about the decision made by government, by municipality, by different actors of political power. And this is parapolitic. Politic is something which is much more wider, and it is understood as a vision of the social life, vision of the public life. And this is everything which is connected with a common, life in a society, with life in a public space, with sharing public space, and about the vision of social life. And the third, metapolitic, is about, this is something which is between the public life and personal life. So this is everything which is the silent sphere of the rules on which we agree, like as a society. And this is the sphere of judgments concerning the basic categories. So this is the sphere in which we agree about the basic categories, like we agree that society means something, foreigner means something, and so on. So metapolitic is something which is very, in fact, wide, and it's connected with everyday life. And so following the reflection of Jack Ranciere, we can say that each participatory theater is political, and following the reflection of Paweł Mościcki, we can say that it is every time it is political, but it can be political in different way. And here you have the examples of the and I come to examples now, to the different participatory theater in the public space, which are parapolitical, political, or metapolitical. And the first one, which is parapolitical, is the Forum Theater by Augusto Boal. Political is, in the political way, existed Barters by Eugenio Barba. And metapolitical is Caroling by Vengaity Theater. So as I said at the beginning, these two first examples are very famous, very well known in the whole world, for sure in the theater world. And the last one is also well known, but rather in Poland, and I guess also here in Germany. And this is contemporary example. And so let's go quickly on this example. So here we have Augusto Boal, who was the director and the inventor of the Theater of the Oppressed initiatives. And Augusto Boal was Brazilian, and he was inspired by Bertolt Brecht works. And he was looking how we can use theater to fight for the rights of the people who are, in this work, who are in this in this group, which is workers group, yeah. And lots of times he used the expression that theater should be the rehearsal of revolution, of the revolution which makes these people more active and more sure about their rights. And one of the forms he developed was the Forum Theater. And Forum Theater was the, this is the contemporary example from Zambia. And contemporary theater has changed a lot of times. He changed on his own, his later cooperators changed as well. And nowadays, those who practice Forum Theater do it also in a different way, but the main principle is still the same. So this is the principle that firstly we show the performance without interruption, and the performance is about a very important social issue for some group of people, and then we show the performance for the second time, and we invite people to interrupt to the performance, to come on the stage and to change what protagonists of the performance do. So this is the way how people can react on the some situation, and how they can change the situation in the theater during the performance, and also during the discussion, which is also created by the actors of the performance, and which in Boal's mind can in the future reflect in their activities to be more, as I said, sure about their rights and to change their situation. So always the topic of the performance was very political, and also some representatives of the local government were invited to participate in the performance to show them how it works from the people's point of view. And nowadays, I have to say that here is another example of the. Here we have the Augusto Boal in the corner, and he is another contemporary example from New York. And here we have the example from Bulgaria. As I said, the Forum Theater changed. And nowadays, from my side, unfortunately, but you know, it depends on the perspective. Nowadays, it is used as a tool for a therapy. It is used as a tool to work with people with who are addicted, with youngsters from some houses, security houses. With people with different disabilities and so on. So it is used not in such a parapolitical way like it was invented, but it in a more therapeutic way to prepare the therapy for the people. So I can say that it loses its parapolitical character, but it still exists. And the second example is the Barters by Odin Teatret and Eugenio Barba. And again, Odin Teatret is a well-known theater group. Eugenio Barba was the collaborator of Jerzy Grotowski, and then he involved his own theater group in the 60s. It was 1964 in Oslo, and then they moved to Holstebro in Denmark, in which they live until now. And I have to say that for the first year of Odin Teatret existence, it was just the laboratory theater. They were mostly interested in their arts, in preparing performances and showing them in front of well-educated audience. I mean, not only in front of them, but we can imagine who come to see such a performances. And then something changed because they moved to Carpignano, which is the village in Italy, And just to practice there, you know, just to do the same, but there. And when they came there, just by accident, barter happens for the first time. And later it becomes one of the most well-known formats of their work. And what is barter? So barter is the presentation before the audience, local audience, short form of entertainment, like songs, talks, dances, and so on, and which are specific for this group of people who are presenting, you know, these forms of entertainment. And then we have the big change, because the audience becomes the actors, and local people are invited to show their works, their songs, their dances, their local form of culture. And barters were formed in many places in the world, in very different communities, and also in a very difficult times, like in Peru in 1978, it was the time when all gatherings were illegal in Peru. They prepared the barters there as well. And as you can imagine, the topic of the barter, the topic of its performers, it's not about politics at all. I mean, it is not the topic is not strictly political, but how they do this is, of course, very political, because they invite people to act together, to gather together, to see that they can, that they have something in common, that they can share what they have in common, and they encourage people to act actively in the public sphere. So even though the topic is not very political, the way how it works, of course, is. So this is how it works, and here is the contemporary example from the barters from Holstebro in Denmark. Okay, and the last example is the Vengajty Theater from Poland. As I said before, I'm the part of Vengajty Theater. So the Vengajty Theater was established in 1986 and was founded by Erdmute and Wacław Sobaszek. And they practice caroling. They practice lots of things, but also caroling. And caroling for them was very important from the beginning of its existence. And they were looking, firstly, because of the fact that they were looking for different social behaviors outside the big cities. And they were also looking for songs, dances, and cultural rites from the different parts of Poland, from different villages, to combine them together and to prepare the performance. And here is very old photo from the beginning of their work. And so it was the beginning of the Vengajty Theater, but later they started being more interested not only in asking people about their reads, about their songs and so on, but also they were interested in becoming, in doing people more active in its own cultural forms of behavior. So caroling was for them the one possibility to active local communities in different Polish villages by coming to them with, in fact, their own from the but form of behavior which does not exist anymore, but it's still alive in the memory of the elderly people from these villages. And one short remark that we are here talking about the public space, and I would like to also say that public space is, of course, something which is mostly considered as an urban issue, But in fact, in villages, there is also, you know, private and public space. And it is also interesting to put our attention on the public space in the villages. Artists entered the role of carolers, but as you can understand, they learned how to be the carolers because of the specific theatrical training. They did know it on their own. They did not rise up with this knowledge. They just learned it. So the caroling by them, it's not anymore ritual. It is rather theatricalized ritual, because they behave like their imagination and their knowledge say them that they should behave. And they are actors. In fact, they are not preparing it as it should be prepared by local people in the situation when everybody knows what is caroling, and in the situation when it is still practiced. So they are actors, and the rituals is theatricalized. And also we should say that that not only they are actors, but also actors are those who host them, because caroling is about hosting carolers in front of house or inside the house believable that it brings happiness to home when carolers are coming. So the hosts, people, the inhabitants of the village are also actors, because they also didn't know, lots of them didn't know about these rites, yeah? They didn't know about it, they had to learn it, how to do this. So we are here compared with the theater, yeah? Example of the participatory theater, because we have to engage people to act together, to participate in our performance. And I have to say that the content of the caroling by Van Gaite theater is openness, in fact, because they are interested in visited people, their lives, views, and experience, and it results in the presentation with the atmosphere of openness, because you have to open your door to invite people to come together. In the situation when even villagers don't meet very often, it's important to see that opening the door for carolers is very important act of being open. So once again, caroling is a spectacle of openness and tolerance and interest in all the villagers, regardless of their social, financial, economical, whatever status. And this is, of course, very metapolitical, because it shows how we can behave with each other. Yeah, here is one more photo about Van Gaite theater. As you can see, here is the photo and here is the book. Okay, and some conclusions. So I have to say that there is no parallelism between the development of political commitment and the level of participation. So it means that there is no such a thing that the more politically involved some performance is, the participation is greater. The second thing is that it is clear that participatory theaters are different, involved in different times of their activity, so somehow they are, and also each performance of the participatory theater is differently politically engaged, so we should, when we want to know how political engagement looks, we should focus on each performance in and be specific with the concrete example. And the last thing is that each participatory theater push its political vision about the about the sharing power with people, expanding opportunities between people to participate in decision-making process. And participatory theater itself is based on the cooperation of people. And this, in the same time, is the vision of the politic which it represents. So thank you for your attention, and here's contact to me. I will be glad to answer all your questions. Thank you.